This is a video request for Adventure Island Anglers. Attaching the sail lines to the top of the roll bar prevents the lines from knocking the rods into the water. My first rod holder design looks similar to a roll bar and works really great. The sail opened only 90% and the height of the roll bar affected the angle of the sail, but it was all good. As the months went by, so did the changes to my roll bar. I lowered the conduit arch and added a 45-degree elbow so the sail would open 100%. With the sail fully open, what a big difference it made. I also designed a splash kite just to keep me dry. When the wind is blowing, even the smallest waves can get you wet. If you're wondering if the splash kite affected the speed, take a look. 6.5 on the GPS. The ocean is a big playground, and having the Adventure Island is a great vessel to get one spot to the next. I made this splash kite in the shape of a diamond, just an emergency if you need to use your kayak paddles. You have lots of room. As you can see, the new rod holder design keeps everything in place. In these pictures, notice the white 45-degree elbow I added to improve the roll bar. To prevent any damage to the molded rod holders, I suggest buying this 1-inch bar stool crutch and insert it on the bottom of your roll bar. That way it will protect it from any damages. The roll bar experiment goes on. I wanted to keep the original angle of the sail, so I redesigned the roll bar again and lowered the belled conduit just to hold a dry box and keep the rods in place and the lines from knocking over the poles. With this new design, I had to make sure that the sail lines don't get cut up with the rods and knock it over, so I made some bungee cords to hold the rods down. Here's a better look of the third design. See the bar stool on the bottom of the legs? They're used to protect your kayak from damage. And here's a picture without paint. Notice my Scotty mounts? Scotty products are affordable and way to go. I have two trapeze for crab pulleys, one triple rod holder, and one lake troller. They all work good. I tried them all. Very good units. I just replaced my old Scotty mount and used Daniel and Efren's technique to attach the base to the akkas using the material that they use called rubbers. As Daniel will say, rubbers! Working with 1/8-inch thick aluminum, you'll need two strips to cut, and I used 5-inch, but I messed up because it was too short. It's best not to leave any gaps in between your aluminum and your base, so I suggest 5.5-inch strips and smooth out the ends before bending the aluminum around the akkas. Check out their channel. It's Beyond the Breaker, Ivory Dagger, DFAM, Living Waters, and also Adventure Islanders. Before bending it, smooth out the edges. That way it'll save you time. Remember, use stainless steel if you're in contact with salt water. That way, if you need to remove it, you won't have any problems. This was my first attempt to attach the Scotty mount on the akkas. So if you decide to reposition the angle of the mount, you know, it's up to you. I've seen it done. Notice how close the clamps are to the base. That is the perfect fit. Oh yeah, Daniel and Efren really picked a good material to use for holding this Scotty mount to the akkas. These rubbers work really, really good. Thanks, guys. I placed the Scotty mount as closest to me as possible. You could find this piece in the plumbing department. In cutting it in half, try to get it as even as possible. As soon as that's done, cut the center part of the rubbers out. Then you'll be left with the two outer parts. Cut the midsection in half. And that's used for the base. Pick a preferred spot where you want to mount the Scotty base and tape it down, or what I did was use electric tape to hold it before I strapped Make sure you pick a good spot where you want to put the Scotty mount. Go ahead and check out their channel. They got tons of love for you guys. Here at 5.5 inches, really nice fit. And the bottom clamp is 5 inches. It was too short, so I cut it and threw it away and redid it all over again. The closer to the base, the better. And cut excess bolt. I really like Scotty products. They have a wide variety to select, and they're made pretty tough. The triple mount is awesome. This is a must have on your kayak. These are microphone cords. Okay, what I did was attach a Scotty clip to both ends using bungee clips. To use this cord, one end you attach to your reel and the other end you attach to your paddle cord. Using the Scotty clips are really good because they don't get rusted and there's no sharp objects on it, so you don't have any problems scratching your reel. And that's what I do. I attach it to the reel, and if you notice on your kayak, there's a built-in bungee cord on the side. Put all the cords attached to that. What about a cooler for your kayak? You know, a lot of people want a little bit more space or something to put their bait in, but this one right here I'm using is a 35 quart cooler. I had extra parts from Hobie, so I just attached a bungee cord system to keep it locked shut down tight. This is my final look of the newest rod holder, and I hope you like it. It holds 6 rods, and if you decide to troll, it can carry 1 rod on each side. Now I have more space. Don't forget, guys, get yourself a 1-inch bar stool tip slash crutch to protect the bottom of your molded rod holders. The size of my rocket launcher is 1 1/4 PVC, and I also inserted a 1-inch PVC with the bar stool tip crutch to protect the molded rod holder of your kayak. I also drilled a hole in the bar stool crutch so the water will drain out if it's trapped. The PVC rod holder weighs about 15 pounds with the added stainless steel rod holder attached to it. I attached rod holder cap to give it that nice look and to protect the fishing rods. I removed the conduit pipe and use a regular PVC that will be above the crossbar. My last advice for the 2000 AI is be careful with car topping that you don't damage the drain plug or the rudder pin. I've been using a child-size bean bag to help assist a quick, easy load. The idea of having the bean bag is using it to protect the bottom of your kayak from getting damaged from your drain plug or your rudder pin, and it also helps from sliding back and forth when you're car topping. So as soon as you bring up the front end, the back end will be sitting into the bean bag and it will hold it right in that same spot without even moving. You'll be surprised. Here we go. I'm going to lift up this kayak and look how nice and easy it is using the bean bag. To get a better grip, open up the hatch. It makes it really easy. Before car topping the kayak, I tilt it upside down and take out any water that's inside of it. I transport the AI on its belly, so I made a wide saddle to prevent dents. Just slip it under and strap the kayak on top, and it doesn't even move at all. Making the saddle 15 inches wide, it will help avoid any dents to the hull of the kayak. Happy 4th of July, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys soon. This is Rudy, aka Halibut77, out.